Notion is helping me plan my dream 2022. While I have learned a lot about creating systems in the past year, goals are the point where I have worked back from in order to create those systems that allow me to achieve them. As Tim Ferriss talks about in his book, The 4-Hour Workweek, dreamlining is an exercise developed to help you achieve your ideal lifestyle. The focus is on thinking big, defining steps, and applying timelines to your dreams. With the grouping feature in Notion, we can take this dreamlining concept from Tim Ferriss and make it a reality. So in today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to set up a dreamline slash goal template using Notion. If you want to get this, you guys can go into the link down below. I actually am using this as my first paid slash premium version of Notion templates. But for any of the premium ones I ever make, I will make sure that I show you in its entirety how to make said template in Notion so that I'm giving you the value for free. But if you want to save some time, you can go and purchase that at my Gumroad website. So let's dive right into how to make this goal template in Notion. So to first start this all off, let's make this a full length page and go to goals and the top, and then we can do a little check mark or something like that. Do a little cover, maybe change it to an unsplash that has something to do with goals. So what I like to do at the top is then take a slash gallery. So it's gonna be an inline gallery database. So we can actually call this brainstorming. And what I like to do here is take the different parts of your life. So different things, like if we take all these and take them blank, so we can do personal. And a lot of these properties aren't going to be anything crazy outside of one property that I want to show, which is going to be can either be a multi-select or just a select, but let's do multi-select and go year. Let's go 2021. Obviously there's going to be 2022 soon. So actually let's take this and make this a select. So personal, person. I like the little silhouette. Go personal. And then for me, I'd also have business. Or you can do financial probably. Let's do financial. Or we're going to do 2022 since that's the year coming up. Let's do 2022 for both of these. Keep going here, work goals. And then if we're someone who's in school, we can obviously do school goals as well. And then here, if you want to take an extra property and go to files and media and go cover image. Basically, if you upload something here, once we go and take these properties, and as we can see properties, we can have the card preview be based on the cover image. So then if we upload something, like if we go to pexels.com for some stock photos, we can do money. Just download this. Go right back into this goal section. If we add this cover image of money. Could take this, and the same goes for all the other ones. So I'm going to quickly go and make these look aesthetic for you guys. So now in order to make this something that can be changed over time, we have this center set up in a way where there is a filter that we can change things over time. But first and foremost, what I want to show you is the fact that for this top brainstorming center, we can make a template that is along these lines. So you can see here, it's going to be, what do you want to achieve? How can I achieve this goal? Or what do I want to achieve? How can I achieve this goal? What habits do I need to build? When will I achieve this goal? So if we take this and put this into all of these different ones and then make a template at the top right here. So if we go new template, goal, or brainstorming template, then we paste this guy right in here. So anytime you want to make a new one, you can obviously go in here and do that. We could add some emojis here to add some aesthetics, by the way. What we can do in order to make this filtered by different years is, if we add a filter, year is 2022. So all of these are going to be filtered out for that. So if we added a new view, we can call the first one the
2022 brainstorming, or just goals, whichever you prefer. Then if we want to take something like this, turn this into 2023 filter, we can like change one of these to 2023. Then we move this filter right here to say year is 2023. And then the same goes for something like if we wanted to go back and make a 2021 one, if we were somebody who was in that time, but we only are gonna work with these 2 years here. So for 2022, these are the goals we have. And then what I like about this setup is with the new grouping feature in Notion, if you make a board view, an inline board view, you can go and do something called Dreamlines. So the Brainstorming Center is gonna be more of the place where you have the ideas for all your different sections, but for the Dreamline section, it's similar to in Tim Ferriss, where we can literally map out what we're wanting to do. So for me, what I really like about this is the fact that if you take the Kanban board view, you can set it up so you use the grouping feature that Notion kindly made for us. So what we're gonna do here is we're gonna set up the different properties. So for year, we can have it in a similar sense of, all right, we got 2021, 2022, and 2023. Now, if we want to go and look really quick, it's going to be green, purple, gray, light gray. Green, purple, light gray. So if we go back in here, make sure we have the colors the same. All right, so if we pop in here, we can now see that there's going to be different types of years in there, but what matters as well is another select property, which is going to be month. So then what we can do is we can type these guys out. So we can do full name or short name. I'll do full name really quick, fill these out. So now that we've done all of these, what we can do is we can add another one, which would be select, and it's gonna be life bucket. So I'm somebody who believes in the different life buckets, and this could be the personal, financial, physical, work goals, school. But for me specifically, I also had things like YouTube, podcasts, sales funnels, the different finances. So for us, let's do physical goals, or let's do financial goals. Then let's do physical goals. Then we can do overall life goals. So the nice thing here is that we have different things broken out by a nice level of different specificity. And what we can do here is if we take this, we can have it be grouped by the month. What we then can do is go into these three dots here and then go to subgroup and subgroup by the life bucket. So as you can see, it's going to break things out by, does it have no life bucket? Is it financial? Is it physical? Is it life? And I personally am somebody who tries to categorize most things. So I want to hide the no life bucket one. So let's just drag these somewhere. And then what we can do here is we go subgroup, we can hide the no life bucket. And then the same goes for this over here. As we can see, what we're gonna have is a very nice long Dreamline view of our different goals. And how we can take this a step further is we can do something very similar to the top section, and we can have it filtered where year is 2022. So then if we make another board view, a nice simple trick, by the way, is just to duplicate the first one and delete the new one that it forces you to make. So if we go 2022, Dreamlines, it's filtered to where year is 2022, and then 2023. Filtered where year is 2023. So then what we can do here is we can take something like these financial goals and we can say, okay, well, I want to have a paycheck of, or a annual salary earned, you know, I want to get that raise by February. Raise at job. So we have this here. And what we can do, which is nice, is if we want to make any sort of relation, we can go to add a property, relation, and then we can go back to the other database, which is the Brainstorming Center. create relation. So then what I can do is I named this one financial. Now, if I wanted to do something like this, I could, or we go and we do a little 2022 here or something like that. So then we can go and make sure it's the right one. Or what's a nice trick is if you want to just keep it just financial and just change it every year, we can go copy link. And then if we paste this in here, it'll connect it to the right Brainstorming Center financial. So then here, for example, if you had goals you want to write out, so it's like, what do I want to achieve? I want a raise this year. How can I achieve this goal? Asking my boss for the extra work it would take to get there. What habits do I need to build? Better deep work habits and less distractions. When will I achieve this goal? February. So then you can work here and go raise a job. So then we write in here, say you want to get raised to $50,000 a year. Annual salary. And that's your raise. We can go through here and say all different types of physical. So what do I want to achieve? I want to do 100 push-ups a day. How can I achieve this goal? Starting small with 20, 30, 40, 50, etc. push-ups a day goal. What habits do I need to build immediately? Doing workouts when I wake up. When will I achieve this goal? I want to achieve it by next June. Now, obviously, I'm already there, but for example, for the physical ones, we can go, okay, this is what I'm going to do, 20 push-ups a day. Start with 10. Let's go to 40. 60 push-ups a day. 75 push-ups a day. 90 push-ups a day. And then 100 push-ups a day. And we can see the different dream lines that we can make here of like, this is when I want to reach the certain thing. And then a nice final piece de resistance for this would be, we go to a status, little checkbox one, checkbox. So then if we go through these different months, we can set the properties here to show this checkbox. And then as the months go on, we can check this off and be like, hey, I reached my goal eventually when I get there. And then we can obviously go and make sure that in the 2023 ones, we had a little checkbox property as well. And then you could see something like this regarding personal. I want to take more vacations. How can I achieve this goal? Saving up for it starting at the beginning of the year. What habits do I need to build? Stop going out to drink coffee from Starbucks. When will I achieve this goal? Let's say next, December. So then what we can do here is we go December vacation in the Bahamas. A little palm tree here. And then what's nice is we can go through this year and obviously we can keep adding things and we can figure out in the different life buckets what we want to do, what habits we can build, and what dream lines we have. We're seeing that like, yeah, I'm going to hit this raise at a job by then. I'm going to hit 100 pushups a day by then. And we can also do the little ones along the way. So it's nice here in my opinion. And I have a goals one that I have for myself. As you can see, I have all sorts of stuff and plans for you guys that's a little bit behind the scenes of what I'm thinking about doing. So this is stuff that I really have big goals for next year, and I want to help you guys reach yours by showing you this as well.
If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button, subscribe, and hit the notification bell, and make sure to press this end card right here in order to check out all of my other Notion videos. With that being said, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.